Hello, and thank you for tuning into the program today. I'm your host, Neal Howard, here on Health Professional Radio. Our guest today is Dr. Matthew Kaufman. He's the only known expert in the world to perform surgery on phrenic nerve injuries, and he's here today to discuss phrenic nerve injury, one of his cases, and the textbook that he and his colleagues from the Institute for Advanced Reconstruction have collaborated on, Rehabilitative Surgery, a Comprehensive Text for an Emerging Field. Welcome to Health Professional Radio, Dr. Matthew Kaufman.
Thank you. Great to be here.
Now, being the only known expert in the world must have some advantages to it, I'm sure. Give us a bit about your background. What exactly is it that you're involved in as a surgeon?
Sure. I'm a plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I also have a board certification in head and neck surgery. And my specialty in phrenic nerve surgery happened sort of by chance, given that I'm part of a group that focuses on injuries to peripheral nerves throughout the body. And due to the specifics of my training, I was well suited to tackle this particular problem, which we started focusing on about 12 years ago, and patients were inquiring about treatments for this disorder, and I did some research and put together a protocol, and fast forward 10, 12 years later, we've treated about 350 patients from every country in the United States and even patients throughout the world.
So talk about this disorder. What does it entail and who does it affect?
It's a disorder that causes paralysis of the diaphragm, which is the primary muscle of breathing. So it's the inspiratory muscle that is the force of breathing. Without it, it's difficult to inhale air into the lung. And patients who have paralysis of the diaphragm, in essence, are breathing off of one lung. If one side's injured or if both sides are injured, they're in really bad shape because neither lung is working well. In the most extreme example, which is spinal cord injury, neither side is working, and patients are on mechanical ventilators. And so we focus on fixing the problem that's in the phrenic nerve through a series of techniques that fall under the realm of peripheral nerve reconstruction. And we use that for various nerves throughout the body. But we've been adapting these techniques for problems with the phrenic nerve.
Are these problems caused by an injury, some type of stress, or is it something that a person can just develop based on genetics?
It's really all the above. Many times, probably more than 50% are due to either some kind of traumatic injury in the neck or chest, or as a result or inadvertently of a surgical procedure where the nerve has been injured, if there's a cancer being removed or if work is being done in the vicinity of the phrenic nerve. The other 50% really are not, do not have clear causes, but they seem to be a result of what we call wear and tear, similar to patients that have carpal tunnel syndrome, where your fingers go numb due to compression of the nerves. There's not always a direct cause, and we're seeing the same thing with this injury, that sometimes it's just chronic degeneration in the neck that causes this injury.
So chronic degeneration in the neck that commonly causes this injury. Are we talking it's possible just to get old and this injury occur and basically nothing can be done about it at that stage, or is it never too late to correct the problem?
Typically, first of all, it's a pretty rare disorder. It's not to scare people that they're going to suddenly develop this. Secondly, is it's usually in someone that's led a pretty active lifestyle, played football in their youth, had a job with manual labor, lifting things on their neck or shoulder. Typically there is something that can be done, even if the injury's been there for a while. Obviously, the longer it's been going on and the weaker the muscle, the harder it is to fix the problem. But we've treated patients successfully even after 10 or 12 years of injury. We can reverse the problem.
The Institute for Advanced Reconstruction has done, as you say, over 300 of these cases. Let's discuss briefly a specific case that stands out in your mind.
Yes, we recently, we've had, thankfully many, many successes. Recently, one that comes to mind because it was such an overwhelming success early on this gentleman had an injury where he was a young, healthy person that was living a very vibrant, active lifestyle. And suddenly, you know, when this occurred, he was completely debilitated. He couldn't mow his lawn. He couldn't exercise. Even walking up a flight of stairs, he was completely gassed. And he was suffering. He was depressed. He couldn't imagine living the rest of his life this way. And for a long time was being told that there's nothing that could be done. Fortunately, he was able to find our center, and we evaluated him and determined that he was a candidate. Mm-hmm. The surgery was performed, and then there's a very aggressive protocol for therapy afterwards to strengthen the muscle. And he has far surpassed all milestones. He's about 6 months out now. And usually at 6 months, patients are, you know, 20% better, 30% better. But this gentleman has done so well that he's now, you know, resumed all physical activity, exercise, you know, mowing his lawn again, and, you know, has basically recovered just about all of his breathing capacity. You know, is obviously very appreciative, and his quality of life has improved significantly.
You know, I'm going to go ahead and date myself. And I saw a movie many, many, many years ago called Jacob's Ladder, where a guy went to a chiropractor, had his neck snapped, and basically went to another world or whatever. Now, not that that can happen, but many of us go to the chiropractor, or we get a crick in our neck or something, and we pop our neck, have it an adjustment. A part of an adjustment, right, is the neck pop. What about a person who regularly goes to their chiropractor or has someone crack their neck over the course of many years? Is that something that could cause this injury?
You're right on target. You know, without disparaging the chiropractic specialists, you know, certainly we've seen dozens of patients who that seemed to be the cause, where they had gone, you know, over and over for months or years to have their neck manipulated. And that was the most likely cause of their phrenic nerve injury. There are also several reports in the medical literature documenting that can cause phrenic nerve injury. And so, you know, while there may be a role for chiropractic in the neck, I do think that there's also a risk. And just like with any other treatment, you have the benefits and the risk. And I think repetitive neck manipulation with cracking, so to speak, mm-hmm. you know, can certainly over time lead to a phrenic nerve injury.
Now, you and your colleagues there at the Institute for Advanced Reconstruction have created what's being called a first of its kind textbook.
Yeah, so it's very exciting. We have put together a variety of surgical treatments, such as the phrenic nerve surgery, but also a whole host of other things that many people in the world and many physicians may not even be aware of. You know, it's a combination of things that are standard and widely accepted and longstanding, and it's also things that are groundbreaking, innovative, and things that we've been researching. And basically, it's a new subspecialty called rehabilitative surgery. So for treatments for patients with paralysis and different types of nerve damage, things that we can do to improve their quality of life, their function. And for example, you know, spinal cord injury, there's no cure. And we're not claiming that we have a cure, but there are things we can do outside of the spinal cord using peripheral nerve surgery to improve certain facets of these individuals' lives. So, for example, you know, getting off of the mechanical ventilator and breathing independently, mm-hmm. preventing pressure sores, maybe getting bladder function back. So certain things, certain aspects of their paralysis that might be the most debilitating consequences that we can sometimes help. And so we've put together this textbook to educate and enlighten both the clinicians that may deal with these patients and the public at large.
And where can we go and get more information about you, the Institute for Advanced Reconstruction, as well?
So our website is probably the easiest access to our institute. It's advancedreconstruction.com, and that has information about our physicians and the special treatments that we offer. We have also information about our concierge travel program, because obviously we have a lot of patients traveling to to seek treatment in our center. Mm-hmm. The website would also have information about our textbook and or through the publisher's website, which is Springer Link, which is the publisher.
Well, I appreciate you coming in and talking with us today, Dr. Kaufman.
Thank you so much for having me. It was great being here.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neal Howard, in studio with Dr. Matthew Kaufman, the only known expert in the world to perform surgery on phrenic nerve injuries. Transcripts and audio of this program are available at healthprofessionalradio.com.au. You can also listen in on SoundCloud. Be sure to visit our affiliates page when you visit our platform at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au.